Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillah, today we meet again in Zoom room. By the way, today we will discuss about the new chapters. Because I think yesterday we have daily test. And some of you have done, and maybe some of you haven't. Yeah. So I think, yeah, we have to study hard and really hard to finish all of our assignment, because there are some effect to the final report. Okay, today we will discuss, and I have prepare one PowerPoint, one slide that I'll present to you before starting my presentation. I need to say hi to you all. Okay, today we will learn about the layer of the earth, or earth's layer, yeah. And I have prepared here this one. Okay. Now we discuss about this. Okay. Okay. Inside the earth, we will learn about the inside of the earth, and also actually not only the inside, yeah, but also the surface of the earth, yeah. And now, okay, okay, the center of the earth. Earth layers. Mbak Diva, assalamualaikum. Mbak Diva.
Ya, Pak.
Okay, would you like to read this one? Please.
The earth is divided into four main layers. Inner core, outer core, mantle, crust.
Okay. Earth layers. Earth layers. The earth is divided into four main layers. Yeah. The earth is divided into four main layers. The first inner core, and then outer core, and then mantle, and the surface of the earth is crust. And the crust also divided becoming two, yeah, into two main
continental.
Yeah, main layers. Okay, this one, the inner core, and then outer core, and then mantle, and then crust. Yeah, crust. Okay, this is these are the part of our earth, the layers of our earth. Yeah. Okay, now we go to the crust. Mas Raka, read the text, please.
The crust. The earth's crust is like the skin of an apple. It is very thin compared to the other three layers. The crust makes up 1% of the crust of the earth is broken into many pieces called plates.
Okay, thank you very much. The earth's crust is like the skin of apple, of an apple, yeah, skin. Why we compare with the apple? Because the scale, yeah, and the ratio between the crust and the other parts of the earth so big, yeah. The comparison, I mean the thickness of the crust if we compare with mantle and then outer core, inner core is so different. Yeah. So that's why in my slide, the earth's crust is like the skin of an apple. It is very thin compared to the other three layers. So if we compare with the others, so like skin of an apple. The crust makes up 1% of the earth. The crust only 1% of the earth. All of the earth, the crust is only 1%. The crust of the earth is broken into many pieces called plates. So all of the surface of the earth, the name is the crust. But the crust is broken into many pieces. And we usually call plates. This one. Okay, outer core, inner core, mantle crust, Indian Ocean, continent of Africa, and so on. Yeah. Okay, now I need help from Mbak Fania to read the text, please.
The crust is only about 3 to 5 miles. Or 8 kilometers thick under the oceanic crust and above 25 miles, 32 kilometers thick under the continental crust.
Okay, thank you, Mavania. The crust is only about 3 up to 5 miles. 5 miles can be converted in kilometers become 8 kilometers because 1 miles equal with 1.6 kilometers. 1 miles, 1 mile equal with 1.6 kilometers. So if 5 miles equal with 8 kilometers thick under the ocean, usually we call it oceanic crust, and about 25 miles or 32 kilometers thick under the continental crust. Oceanic crust is crust under the sea, But the continents crust. Continental crust is without sea, the continent of the earth. Okay, the crust, this is the crust. This one, the continental crust and oceanic crust. As I said, or as the previous slide, that oceanic crust, the thickness about 3 to 5 miles, but for the continental crust is about 25 miles. Yeah, 25 miles. So the thickness of the crust is different. Yeah, this one. Yeah, this is the thickness of continental crust, and then this one is oceanic crust. Crust is crust itu adalah kerak bumi ya. Bahasa ininya apa namanya? Ya, kerak bumi bahasa Indonesianya. Keras. Oke. Okay. Any questions? No. Oke. Okay. Outer layer 5 to 100 kilometers. The types of crust, like I said, that oceanic very dense, made of basalt, continent, less dense, made of granite. Do you know very dense? Very dense like rapat, padat, ya, lebih padat. Very dense, sangat padat, sangat rapat susunannya. Less dense itu lebih renggang, lebih rapuh, massa jenisnya lebih kecil. Very dense, it means that the density bigger. Less dense, it means that the density lower than very dense, yeah, dense, yeah. Okay, this is the condition of crust, special for oceanic crust and also continental crust. Even though oceanic crust only about 3 to 5 miles, but the oceanic crust very dense, sangat keras, ya. Based on the picture, you know, you see that, yeah, dark for the oceanic crust, dark, yeah. The continental crust brighter, yeah, brighter. Okay, this is the illustration between oceanic and continental crust, yeah. Okay, like this. You can imagine, yeah, the deepness of the sea based on this this picture, yeah. So deep. Okay. This is also the condition between crust and mantle, yeah. Crust and mantle. There is continent crust and then oceanic crust and then upper mantle. Upper mantle, it means the mantle at the top position. Upper, lebih atas, ya. Lebih atas. And then there is a magma. Magma will be discussed for the next meeting, ya. Magma about volcano. Okay, now granite or older basalt younger, ya. Kontinen itu dari granit, kalau oceanic crust itu dari basalt. Lebih tua kontinental, ya, daripada oceanic crust. Okay, the mantle. Mas Raka, sudah ya Mas Raka ya? Mbak Sarah, read the text, please.
The mantle is the layer below the crust. The mantle is the largest layer of the earth. The mantle is divided into regions, the upper and lower section.
Okay, thank you. Very good. Thank you. The mantle is the layer below the crust. So this is the crust, and the below of the crust is mantle. This is crust and then mantle. The mantle is the largest layer of the earth. The largest, yang paling, ya, yang paling banyak, yang paling tebal, yang paling besar volumenya, the layer of the earth is mantle, ya. Yeah? The mantle is divided into two regions, the upper and lower section. Ya, yeah? Mantle crust and then below the crust is mantle. Mantle divided into two, upper and lower, ya, yeah? Upper and lower section, ya. Yeah? This is convention actually. I repeat again, the mantle is the layer below the crust, and the mantle is the largest layer of the earth. The largest layer of the earth. The layer of the earth will be crust, mantle, outer core, inner core. And the mantle is the largest layer of the earth. Okay, this one. I think. Yeah, mantle is dominate the others. Mantle is the largest layer of the earth. Okay, now we go to outer core. Mbak Zahwa, please read the text.
Outer core. The core of the earth.
Lovely, please.
The core of the earth is like a ball of very hot metals. The outer core is liquid. The outer core is made up of iron and is very dense.
Very good. Thank you so much. The core of the earth is like a ball of very hot metals. Yeah, some sources say that the core component is nickel and metals. Yeah, will be discussed in this session. And then the outer core is liquid. Yeah, the outer core is made up of iron and is very dense. Very dense, it means that so close, so rigid, rapat. The density, you know, density, massa jenis, the density is so big. So we can say that very dense. The outer core is made up of iron and is very dense. Yeah. So danger, yeah. So danger. Okay. This one. Yeah. Crust and then mantle, yeah. And then outer core, yeah. Iron and nickel, yeah. And then inner core, yeah. But the mantle dominate the others, yeah. Because the mantle is the largest layer of the earth. Okay, any questions? Now inner core, and I need help from Mas Atala Rasha. Okay, read the text.
The inner core of the earth has temperatures and pressures so great that the metals are squeezed together and are not able to move. The inner core is a solid.
Thank you very much. The inner core of the earth has temperatures and pressure so great. Why? There is some cause. Yeah, one of the cause that the pressure so great because of the position. Inner core, outer core, mantle, and then crush. So many burden. Yeah, so many. What is that? So many weight force that push the inner core. So that the earth has the inner core of the earth has temperatures and pressures so great. That the metals are squeezed together and are not able to move, yeah. Squeezes and nggak bisa gerak-gerak, ya. Nggak terlalu banyak gerak. The inner core is solid, yeah. The inner core is solid, yeah. Different with outer core, yeah. Okay, this is the illustration also, only the illustration. How are the earth's layers similar to an egg? Shell, crust. Egg white, mantle. Yolk, core. Maksudnya apa sih? Shell itu ininya, apa namanya? Cangkangnya ya, kulitnya ya. Crust. Egg white, putih telurnya adalah mantle. Yolk, kuning telurnya adalah core atau inti. Okay. Physical structure of the earth. Now I need Mbak Humaira. Please read the text, Mbak Humaira.
Physical structure of the earth. Crust,
Mbak, repeat loudly, Mbak. Mbak Humaira. Okay. Physical structure of the earth. Lithosphere, rigid outer layer, crust. Ya, crust itu lithosphere, itu berada di crust. And then asthenosphere, solid rock that flows slowly, like hot asphalt. Ya. Ada astenosfer itu solid rock yang flow slowly, yang bergerak dengan lambat ya. Nah, lithosphere. Oke. I need help from Mas Iqbal. Read the text.
Lithosphere. Lithosphere is the solid part of Earth. It has the outer, the crust, and the upper mantle. The lithosphere sits on the asthenosphere, the Earth that are the lithosphere. It is the rocky solid portion of the crust. Remember that it is made out of mostly silicon and oxygen.
Okay. The lithosphere or geosphere is this the solid part of the Earth. It has two parts, you know, two parts, the crust and the upper mantle. Yeah. Actually, as I said that, wait, oh my God. Okay. I said that crust, mantle, outer core, inner core, but lithosphere is content of crust and upper mantle, because mantle divided become two, yeah, upper and lower mantle. The lithosphere sits on the asthenospheres. The earth plates and the lithosphere. So we call them. I have presented the crust broken. Become some parts that usually we call plates, yeah. The plates also the lithosphere. It is rocky, rocky. You know rocky? Anybody knows?
Berbatu.
Berbatu. Very good. Solid portion of the crust. Solid, solid itu ada solid, liquid, gas. Yeah. Solid, yeah. Padat, yeah, padat. Remember that it is made up of mostly silicon and oxygen. Have you ever known silicon?
Yes.
Now silicon used for computer, for the storage. Yeah. A few times ago we use magnetic storage HDD. Yeah. Hard disk drive. Now SSD, yeah. What is that? SSD, storage silicon drive maybe. It made from silicon, yeah, from silicon, because yeah, using silicon for store our file smaller than HDD, yeah. Jadi sekarang silicon dipakai untuk teknologi storage. Storage itu untuk penyimpanan file, bisa hard disk, bisa yang lain. Kayak hard disk itu loh dulu. Sekarang kan ada istilahnya SSD, ya. SSD, ya. Okay. Now, asthenosphere. Yeah, we will discuss for the next meeting, actually. This is the illustration of the layer of the Earth. Yeah, there is a continental crust. The thickness about what is that? About 25, yeah, 25 miles. And then oceanic crust. The thickness about 5 miles. Why is that? Continental crust and oceanic crust different the thickness. Yeah, because of the pressure. Yeah, the continental crust only pressed by air, by udara, oceanic crust by water. And even though oceanic crust is thinner than continental crust, but oceanic crust, yeah, more dense, yeah, very dense, sangat keras, sangat rapat, ya, yeah, massa oceanicnya sangat besar. But continental crust less dense. Kerapatannya itu lebih kecil, lebih kurang padat ya dibandingkan dengan oceanic crust. And then lithosphere content of crust and upper mantle too ya. Lithosphere content of crust and upper mantle. Okay. And then plastic asthenosphere and then upper mantle down to 6 and 70 kilometers. So yeah, upper mantle that yeah include with lithosphere, asthenosphere. It's about 670 kilometers. Nah, this one. By the way, for the information, tectonic plates. Yeah, Earth's crust is broken into about 19 pieces. These plates move on top of the asthenosphere. Yeah, ini adalah plate-platenya. Yeah, what is plate? Yeah, plate is a term or the name that parts of the crust that broken. Jadi ada crust yang broken itu nanti yang patah-patah itu, ya itu tidak dinamakan plate. Oke, ya, oke. Okay. Okay. Any questions? I think my explanation so easy for you. And by the way, I also what is that share in virtual class two videos about earth layers, and I need you to watch that and then understand what are the content, and also after that you have to draw the part of the earth, especially for the layers of the earth, from crust and then mantle and then outer core, inner core. If you make it detailed, yeah, of course you will get a good score, you know. Maybe you divide it, the mantle become upper and lower mantle, yeah, and then continental crust, oceanic crust, and also you have to make it in portion. I mean, if for the illustration, the thickness of the continental crust is about 25 miles. You have to make it different with oceanic crust that the thickness only 5 miles, yeah, or about 8 kilometers, yeah. Jadi dibuat beda saja, karena kan beda juga ini ya, apa ketebalannya. Okay. Maybe any questions? Yes.
Bumi kan menghasilkan panas bumi. Kira-kira bagian lapisan bumi manakah yang menghasilkan panas tersebut?
Okay, thank you. So the use of thermal energy from the earth, yeah, we can apply the thermal energy from the earth as a source of the energy. It can be converted to electricity energy. Jadi apa namanya, panas bumi yang dari dalam itu teorinya adalah ini bumi, kemudian there is water at the certain capacity, ada air di dalam, terus di bawahnya ada dekat dengan core, it can be outer core, and make the water boil. Ya, kemudian outer core yang panasnya membuat air ini menjadi boiling gitu, apa, mendidih. Ya, kalau mendidih kemudian we make a line from the water to the crust, kita membuat pipa mungkin line dari air itu ke crust, maka akan keluarlah gas atau keluarlah uap air, karena because of what is that, expansion, because of pemuaian, the water and air expansion and then blow up to the crust. Jadi udara panas pemoyan dari air yang mendidih itu kemudian keluar lewat lubang itu sampai crust. Nah, at crust we put turbine. Kita taruh turbin. And then turbin connected to the generator, electrical generator. Kemudian turbin itu dihubungkan sama generator listrik, maka the generator produce electricity. Gitu. Jadi we can use the thermal energy from the earth geothermal. We usually call it geothermal, ya. Jadi ada energi panas dari bumi that can be convert into the other energy, for the examples kinetic and then electrical energy. Jadi dari panas itu kemudian mendidihkan air yang ada di dalam bumi, kemudian ada saluran keluar. So the evaporation of the water make kinetic energy, menjadi energi gerak pada turbin, and then turbin connected to generator. Turbin itu terhubung dengan generator, so generator convert the kinetic energy become electrical energy. Yeah, that is the implementation of how to use geothermal energy. Okay, maybe any questions? The other questions? There is no calculation at all. Tidak ada perhitungan ya. Kita ini banyak teori aja ini semester 2. In the even semester, most of our materials is about theory. Ya, teori. Banyak teorinya. Okay. Any questions? Okay. After we studying about earth layers, so we can imagine about how to make our environment good. Bagaimana kita membuat lingkungan kita itu baik. Save the earth, ya, kita menjaga bumi, ya. How to use the geothermal? How to use the layers, the potential of the layers of the earth become energy. Maybe for futures, some of you become an engineer, or maybe become Ministry of Energy, menjadi menteri tentang energi, So you can apply your knowledge to produce the energy like electrical energy. Maybe if you know about Japan make nuclear convert to electrical energy. Pakai nuklir yang di Fukushima. Can Indonesian make nuclear energy for electrical energy? Of course, yes. Of course, yes. Some of my lecturers also work in accelerator, yeah? Nuclear accelerator for producing the electrical energy. Jadi dosennya Ustaz Yugo waktu kuliah S1 S2 sebagian juga ada yang bekerja di energi nuklir, ya. Jadi nuklir not only for bombs but also can be used for source of the energy for our daily life needs of what is that, submarine. You know submarine? Do you know submarine?
Kapal selam,
good. Submarine, American submarine.
Nuclear
kapal selam di Amerika, use nuclear for the fuel. Jadi menggunakan nuklir untuk bahan bakarnya. If we use nuclear, the submarine can stay under the sea, about 6 months, you know. Jadi kapal selamnya Amerika yang pakai tenaga nuklir itu bisa di dalam air selama 6 bulan. 6 bulan, you can imagine that.
Kalau pecah gimana nuklirnya?
Oh, insya Allah enggak.
Yang di dalam kapal enggak kena radiasi, apa?
Oh, no. Yeah, maybe if you learn in physics department like me, nanti kalau kuliahnya di jurusan fisika seperti saat juga, nanti diajari there is subject nuclear physics atau fisika nuklir ya. Jadi bagaimana supaya nuklir itu tidak meradiasi terhadap kita sehingga kita tidak terkena paparan radiasi dari nuklir, itu ada caranya ya. Ada barriernya, ada penghalangnya. So there is no bad effect to us ya. Like Chernobyl Chernobyl phenomenon. Jadi di Chernobyl dulu ada meletus ini pembangkitnya dan apa namanya terpapar daerah itu, sekarang menjadi Forbidden City ya, sekarang menjadi ya masih kota terlarang, tidak boleh ke sana. Kalau ke sana nanti terpapar bisa jadi merusak genetis kita, nanti bisa melahirkan anak yang cacat dan seterusnya. Like di tapi kemarin waktu tsunami happen in Japan, Fukushima itu juga terdampak, but because of good handling, karena penanganan yang bagus, it can anticipate, ya, yeah, it can be anticipated, bisa diantisipasi, so there is no radiation to the human. Why Indonesia not start now? Apakah orang Indonesia kurang pinter? Enggak, banyak orang Indonesia pinter, ya. Yeah. Tetapi ya enggak tahulah, nanti kalian tahu sendiri apa sebabnya. Dan juga ya saya enggak bisa bicara di sini ya. Because most of my lecturer in college, in my institute, di ya sebagian dari dosen saya juga di Jerman, di Jepang, di Amerika, juga kadang bekerja di akselerator nuklir yang bisa memproduksi listrik. Ya, I hope most of you become good students, study hard, ya, bisa belajar lebih tinggi. Ya, mungkin kalau Pak Yugo sekarang masih master, nanti kamu jadi doktor gitu. Jadi ya harus hebat ya, dan harus punya cita-cita tinggi. Nanti bisa sharing sama Ustaz Yugo ya. Oke. At the end, I want to give a message to you that we have to strong now. And then, sudah sholat duha atau belum? Ustaz Yugo nggak pamer ya, tapi mau nunjukin bahwa Ustaz Yugo sudah sholat duha. Tadi pagi di sekolah, sholat duha dulu. And I have prepared the slide after subuh. Setelah subuh, saya sudah menyiapkan sholat duha dulu. Kenapa? Ya, supaya Ustaz Yugo berharap pembelajaran kita itu berkah, kalian menjadi pinter tapi tidak keblinger ya, pinter tapi soleh solihah ya, karena apapun itu yang kita capai di dunia ini tanpa kesolehan dan kesolehahan kita itu tidak akan ada artinya, karena di SMM Dallas semuanya diajarkan untuk kita menjadi bahagia di dunia dan bahagia di akhirat. Anak putri khususnya selalu tutup aurat ya, kalau keluar rumah itu dijaga, because itu sudah kewajiban, dan insya Allah Allah pasti akan membalas kepatuhan kita, ketaatan kita kepada Allah ya. Dan kalian semua ini menjadi agent of change ya, menjadi agen perubahan ya, untuk adik-adiknya, untuk kakaknya, mungkin adiknya belum pakai jilbab, adiknya masih berbicara yang kurang baik, atau mungkin bahkan sama ayah bundanya, nggak apa-apa. Misal ayah bundanya hari Kamis seperti ini diajak puasa Senin Kamis, diajak sholat tahajud, mungkin kalau keluar diajak untuk selalu menutup aurat. Insya Allah itu akan menjadi jalan kita menuju kesuksesan. Kesuksesan di dunia dan kesuksesan di akhirat. Ya, anak-anakku semua tetap semangat, tetap bahagia, tetap belajar yang rajin, tetap beribadah yang rajin. Insya Allah, Allah akan selalu membahagiakan kita. Oke. Saya kira cukup ya. I think enough. Thank you for your attention and I'm so sorry if there are a lot of mistakes and because of my English not so good, but I just try my best to teach you, to present the materials in English. If there are a lot of mistakes, I'm so sorry ya. Tapi pokoknya yang penting semangat saja. Saya kira itu. See you for the next meeting. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
See you.